Welcome to Java Talks. I'm your host, Tucker Stout. I'm here with Parker Gregston. Parker, how you doing today, man?
Good, how are you?
Well, welcome to Java Talk. I have a couple questions. So I know you have known you for a while. You played football here. You're a nursing major, and you happen to have diabetes since you were two.
Yep.
How has it been, you know, kind of dealing with all three of those things, being in college, being an athlete, being a nursing major, and having to, you know, battle diabetes all through that time?
It's definitely a full plate at all times, but I think having diabetes since forever, I guess, I'm thankful I didn't get diagnosed coming into college, that's for sure, because I started taking care of it myself at a young age, so I had a good grip of that. But then being an athlete and a nursing major here, like, I feel like that facilitates me around. Like, I'm obviously friends with my teammates, but then I think the teamwork and stuff works itself into the nursing field as well. So I think it's always a full plate, but I think it gives me a good handle of a lot of things.
That's nice. I mean, I can imagine you're super busy. Being a football player, you came here, you were a walk-on, you earned a scholarship. I think you kind of made your big noise in the conference when you had two picks against Augie 2 years ago. You had a pick six. Walk me through that play and the feeling going into the end zone.
I mean, it definitely happened fast. That was my first pick of my college career. That was definitely cool, but I mean, it was just like a third down. They had trips to our side, and it was like third and seven. I'm like, the outside guy's for sure running like a little curl or something. And I was just reading the quarterback, and I saw the receiver break down, and I just broke on the ball, picked it off, and that was it. Honestly, I don't remember. It kind of just goes so fast, but, I mean, yeah.
Those two picks led us to, you know, a game, a huge game against Augie. We had five turnovers, beat them by 40. How did that feel, beating the rivals? Again, that was our third time in our time playing. How did that feel, beating them?
That being the third time, I mean, that was really my first time playing truly against them, so it was definitely, like, a sweet taste. Like, for sure, we smacked them, and but it was nice getting on the field and actually like playing with my brothers, like stuff like that. But it's always, that game is always a fun game.
Yeah. So that led into, you know, you getting this hype around you, talked to a couple scouts, you're training right now for a possible NFL, maybe XFL or CFL. No, with the XFL right now, if that can sustain, that'd be a huge opportunity for you. What's training been like also? You know, you're now training and you're still in school. So, you know, I asked you before, but like, what's training been like? Is it different from just being on the normal football team? And kind of what do you expect to see out of yourself in the next couple of weeks?
It definitely is different because you're training by yourself. So some of those days you're going in, you're like, dang, like, you don't have anybody to train with. But it's kind of the same schedule, you know, you get done with class and you go train, you go to practice, stuff like that. But it's definitely different, but you got to just keep the big picture in mind. Like, this is like the biggest point in my life to go get an opportunity to play.
Absolutely. Yeah. So, you know, you're a nursing major, so what are you looking to do post-college if going to the NFL, CFL?
Work.
Yeah, football doesn't work.
Just
what are you looking to do?
That's out of the picture. I kind of narrowed it down to two different things. I did my preceptor for my senior year at the Avera Heart Hospital in the ER, and I definitely like that, the fast-paced experience. Like, that's definitely my personality. That's kind of what I could see myself doing. And then on the complete opposite end, I could do diabetes education until I die. Like, that is just something that I'm super passionate about. The nurse I talked to for my pediatric days, like, we're still in touch and stuff.
That's
and
cool.
She kind of influenced me of how I take care of my disease today. And she was just always there for me, always making me feel good about myself when I'm coming in to a doctor's at 5 years old. No one wants to go to the hospital when they're five. But so those kind of people influence me as well.
That's sweet. So saying everything works out, you do have a friend from high school that's in the NFL already.
Yeah.
Would you want to play with him again?
Absolutely. That would be so fun.
If not, what's your like go-to destination? If you know, if you had a choice.
Right.
What's your go-to destination?
If not, so my friend's on the Jags. But obviously I'd love to go back home. I'd go to the Broncos, maybe.
Okay, XFL, where would you want to go?
Oh, St. Louis Battlehawks, for sure. they're sweet. Play with Will Hill.
Marquette King.
Yeah, yep,
there you go. So that's cool. You know, that's really awesome to see you pursuing all these things, battling so many different things in college. You know, you have such a full plate. Not a lot of people can do that, which is really impressive. To get through the nursing program, you know, you're almost done here. And get through football, you know, that's something that a lot of people can't do themselves, and it's just really an inspiration to see you, you know, having diabetes and going through all these different things, and it's really amazing, and that's why I want to talk to you today. So, I mean, last question, if you could live anywhere in the country, being a nurse, playing football, anything like that, where would you be and why?
That's a tough question. I do like Boston a lot.
Okay.
My mom's friend lives in Boston, so like I've been there. And the fall is beautiful. Fall for sure is my favorite season. So the trees when they turn is absolutely beautiful. I think that's not my only reason, but it's still, I like the East Coast. I just kind of like the vibes you get out there.
Definitely.
Winters are kind of crazy, but I could deal with it.
Yeah, if you live in East Coast. If you live in Sioux Falls, you can deal with bad winters. So.
Yeah.
Pretty easy. Thank you guys for watching Java Talk. I'm your host, Tucker Stout. This is Parker Gregston.